So welcome back to part two. In this part, I'm going to talk about how you can have a feel in your mind while playing a groove. So if I have to play a pattern like what I showed you in part one, which is We Will Rock You. What are you thinking while you're playing this is also very important. A nice thing to think about is like a shaker running in the background and something which goes something very consistent at a rate you feel comfortable with. So while I'm playing this, the first necessity to do it is so that you've really mastered your groove on the drum, and people are definitely going to move to what you're playing because your timing is bang on. And my suggestion is don't use a metronome while doing this. It only slows you down because you're trying to develop an internal sense of timing. So in my opinion, that comes from you. You shouldn't look at another tool. The metronome can probably be used to make you perfect at the timing. but I wouldn't use it at the initial stages. So this could also improve your timing and get your groove to really lock with the band. So again, demonstrating it. Now, if I were to apply that to the piano, it's the same concept. You play your pattern. Messing around with a few grooves. It's a bit tricky for some music. You may find it easy for some groove and trickier for some other stuff, but it's important to get that groove idea going on, and don't just imagine it in your mind. Try and get it out of yourself. Now, the other reason why having a feel in your head while playing is so that you can bring that feel out on the piano and enhance your groove and take it to the next level. Sort of like what a bass guitar does, what a bass guitarist does on the instrument by playing ghost notes and mute notes, as they call it, or snare drummers giving a lot of buzz rolls and ghost elements there as well. So we can now bring that to the piano. And in the next part, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that.